our first stop is
People's Palace is the municipal hall of Balingasag, established on the year 2011 under the administration of Vice Mayor Alexis Quina.
Its exterior design has used the neoclassical architecture characterized by its long circular columns with volute on its upper part, a spiral scroll-shaped ornament forming the chief feature of Ionic column. It also has long, wide windows to let the light pass through on its interior design. It is also painted with light yellow, making it more attractive and appealing to the eyes. On its interior design, you can immediately see the mesmerizing dome and a chandelier on its center. This makes the building look more spacious and elegant. Indeed, People's Palace is a manifestation of man's hard work and creativity, especially in Balingasag. It is truly a pride not only in the province but the entire region.
Then we visited to the most holy and consecrated grounds of Balingasag, known as the St. Rita de Casia Parish. It is evidently an ancient Jesuit-built structure that began in late 19th century.
Many of the images in the church are antique and appear to be works of Manila's 19th or 20th century workshops, surrounding the congregation and positioned in each deep window niche in a utilitarian fashion of well-crafted, noteworthy images.
The current altar is thoroughly modern without a trace of what we might presume was the pre-war Spanish colonial style retablo with multiple niche and tiers.
It has necessitated the use of a hyper-modern ceiling that brings in lots of natural light and shows the colonial era charm that this structure probably had originally. The windows are old brick lined and are largely intact with grills that are shaped into stunning patterns.
The frontal view of the all-brick facade show of the church with the main doorway and the arch overhead.
The bell tower is a new structure clad with modern ceramic tiles to ape the antique brick church and is a double duty as a four-story parish office. We first took a look at the interior of the Ludenia House, the well-maintained ancestral home of the Ludenia family boasts of its Baroque furniture and fixtures characterized by many decorative parts and details, with wood as the primary material used.
The house features intricately carved wooden vents to let air pass from one room to another, as well as pillars on every corner.
The dining area allows a dramatic use of light as the large window serves as the main source of lighting.
Before we parted, the caretaker of the house shared that the owners of the house, Dr. Lowell Ludenia Sala and Nurse Elden Ludenia Sala Jr., are alumni of Xavier University.
Meanwhile, the exterior of the house boasts of the same attention to detail as the interior. The wooden window shutters allow light to enter, and below the windows are a series of balusters or balustrade, wooden carvings usually used as stair sticks.
So, down to our last stop. We are now here at
Mom Marlin's residence.
Okay, let's go.
Hi, Mom.
Hello.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
The neutral color palette with few splashes of color gives a calm, interesting appeal that will make visitors feel warm and cozy. Furnitures are well chosen that it complemented the totality of the interior.
The house is an example of a modern architecture. It shows simplicity in form, space, materiality, details, and colors. There is no excessive design. A sliding door is used leading to the balcony. Windows are used as design and lines are straight rather than curved.
In one word.
The best.
In one word.
The best.
One word. Okay. Describe Balingasag in one words.
Yes, the modern and the ancient architecture, they exist harmoniously. So it's very, very beautiful to see that again.
Wow.
Balingasag was a great place, and then the travelogue was great because I had a time to appreciate architectural designs and how these people behind those buildings work for it. I mean, if you're the owner, you need a lot of money, and if you're the carpenter, you need hard work. So I think we should also give credits to the people behind those buildings.
It forced us to think critically about buildings, since in this project we have to take into account the different architectural designs, and we have to incorporate it into the different buildings that was in Balingasag. So yeah, it was a great learning experience for us.
And the trip was not merely about ads. It's also about having fun,
and I admit that closer,
we became closer to one another after the trip. Oh.
I'm so happy to be part of this group too. Oh.
Aside from the bonding that we had, I think that the very important part of making this documentary is that we were able to preserve everything that was beautiful in Balingasag.
Balingasag was just a small town, but the minds of the people were so creative, as evidenced by those buildings.
Even if Balingasag is a very small town, the many influences that were incorporated in their architecture was very diverse and very rich.